Please be seated. It's one of the things about this table that it reminds me, it reminds us that we have a union with Christ. We're united to Christ. And we have communion with Christ. We have fellowship with Him. But that's not all that's going on. You've heard me say this before, some of you have, that it's also a reminder that we have union and communion with one another, with His body. We are the body of Christ. And that we are in this together. We are in this journey together. And what Jesus has done for us is He set a table for us in the presence of our enemies, in the midst of peril, that we might feed on Him by His grace, and feed on Him in His love and His mercy for us, that we might be united and redeemed and restored because of His grace. So if you've trusted Christ, if you are a follower of Him, if you've entered into the journey, the mission of God, you would identify that way and you've trusted Him, we invite you to come. Come and feed on Christ and come together. Come knowing that we are in this together. If you haven't trusted Christ, we ask that you pass these elements by, but that is not to keep you out. It's actually to invite you in, to invite you to come with us, to participate and join us in this journey of faith that has the new heavens and the new earth, the restoration of all things in its sight as we go through this together, as we move towards what God is doing in the world. And if that's you, let us know. Let us pray with you. Let us talk to you about what it looks like to believe, to follow Jesus. For I received from the Lord that which I also delivered to you, that the Lord Jesus, on the night in which He was betrayed, when He had given thanks, He took bread and broke it and said, "Take and eat. This is My body, which is given for you." In the same manner, after supper, He took the cup, saying, this cup is the new covenant in my blood. As often as you drink of it, do so in remembrance of me. For as often as you eat of this bread and drink of this cup, you do proclaim Christ and his kingdom until it comes in its fullness. So therefore, let us proclaim the mystery of faith.
Christ has died. Christ has risen. Christ will come again.
Christ, our Passover, has been sacrificed for us.
Therefore, let us keep the feast.
These are the gifts of God for the people of God. Come eat and drink with thanksgiving.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Thank you.
Chairs, But that doesn't mean you need to rush out. Please stay and talk. There's still coffee in the back. We're not doing that to rush you out. It's just part of the setup and takedown we have to do every week. So don't feel rushed just because we're doing that. All right. Now receive the benediction. Now to him who is able to keep you from stumbling and to present you blameless before the presence of his glory with great joy, to the only God, our Savior, through Jesus Christ our Lord, be glory, majesty, dominion, and authority before all time, now and forever. Amen. Amen.